steering group, really. It's all been brought together by the steering group. I have the privilege to chair. It's a very strong and moving and shaking steering group. And we haven't had what we quite often term the usual suspects around it. People have gone to that steering group knowing that there's a commitment that they actually make sure that these sorts of things are happening. What it's done, we obviously can't have everybody around the table, so we've had key people around, but every person around that table has to have links to other sets of the community or the public sector or the private sector, the faith sector, so that we're linked in to everything that's going on. The message is getting far and wide. We have had a lot of interest in it. Partnerships have also formed around the table with people who don't usually see each other in that environment. And I feel myself that the Chamber have been more involved in this since this steering group got itself together than ever. They seem to be mentioned everywhere now. Everywhere you go, they're really getting into it. So they're getting the idea of, you know, how they can be, how they can make a contribution. So partnerships are forming, little bits of work are coming out. So that's a bit like an octopus now. It's, you know, little bits and pieces are coming out. And it's really heartwarming to see how that work is going on and hopefully replicated in other pledges as well. So I'll leave that there. You can ask me anything for the questions.
Thanks, Vanessa. I think we'll take Jamie and then we'll go to sort of questions a bit after you left. I can say thanks very much, Jamie, and then we'll be moving on to us.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Just to add a couple little bits to what Lucy said, really. In terms of the door knock, I think we've seen on the ground the regular door knock, exactly what I never saw about partnerships around the table. We've seen completely different groups of people representing different organisations going out into the community and doing something rather than sitting around the table and talking about it. And the input from a number of people around the table tonight has been really appreciated in actually going out and getting involved in that. We have some quite exciting news about next door knock, which is that Lord Jeff Bilkins, who's the new chair of the Centre for Aging Better, has actually heard about the door knock and is coming up to see it and join in the door knock. And the Jill Cox Loneliness Commission are also intending to come and actually look at the door knock and what we've done in Wirral and some of the steps we've taken towards addressing isolation and loneliness. So some of the work we've done through the strategy is actually putting Wirral on the map nationally, which is fantastic. I think through that we've learned that there's an awful lot of older people who just want to engage in conversation, just want to talk. But some of the formal opportunities, things like the Older People's Parliament, isn't for everyone. We've also learned a lot about some of the perceptions around the younger generation that the older generation have. The Hope with the Great World Conversation is an opportunity to provide opportunities for people just to talk, and it's a very cathartic value to just having a conversation, having a chat, but actually introducing generations together over a particular subject, but using local community coffee shops, local restaurants, local pubs as a setting for that. So we're making use of community assets and very much rolling out an ABCD approach to give people that opportunity to get to know each other, to address some community issues, but also getting people out and about as well. So quite excited to see how that develops. In terms of the Chamber, again, I'd echo what Annette said. It's been fantastic to actually see the Chamber so enthusiastically engage in the strategy. We're working with them around some proposals to use the Chamber's connection and influence over local business to start a pilot project in Birkenhead to actually have age-friendly shops within Birkenhead, somewhere that's got a couple of chairs out, somewhere that a lot of people drink, somewhere where older customers can actually use their facilities. It has a benefit to businesses, but it also has a benefit to older people who are actually telling us that they won't go shopping anymore because they don't know where they can go to the toilet, or they're worried if it's too much and they need to sit down. If that works, and hopefully that's something that we can roll out in partnership with the Chamber right across the borough. And just in terms of dementia, there's been a fantastic push in Wirral over the last 2 years to train as many people as possible to be dementia friends. We're working with Wirral Dementia Action Alliance, which has about 35 members from across the private sector, voluntary sector, community groups signed up to it, to roll out an awareness campaign to really tackle associated with dementia. We're very fortunate to have just elected a new chair to that alliance who has actually supervised it in one of the co-op stores in Wirral. So it's great to actually see the private sector really embracing some of what we're talking about within this strategy. We'll be launching quite a widespread public marketing campaign during March, April of this year. We'll be doing something very specific around National Dementia Awareness Day. And all of this is being achieved using existing assets and resources in a different way. It's not costing anything extra. It's about people's hearts coming together, people really getting behind this strategy, recognising the fact that as council, as an NHS, as organisations, we haven't got additional resources put into this, but we can actually recycle and use existing resources in a different way. I think to me, that's been one of the most successful parts of this, is actually seeing the extent of the difference we can make with very little resources and just applying them slightly differently.
Thank you very much, Jamie, and Annette as well. I'm going to ask if members want to ask questions or any comments on this. Yes, Treena, and then Tony. Between constituency managers and local community groups, and we've got about 18 areas that all want to go there next, and we can't do them all at the same time. We're hoping during the course of this year to cover Leeside, Liscard, New Brighton, Bidston around St James, and also Haswell. We're relying on the goodwill of statutory partners.
fluid, because some people who find that they can't come will send someone else, and then that person might, take over for a bit. So it is fluid, but we think we've got most connections covered, one way or another.
Could you share the members with me?
Yes, of course.
Thanks for the invitation. children in Wirral, first thing you need to do is to know yourself. So we've got a population of around 70,000 children who live in Wirral and grow up in Wirral. What we need to know about Wirral is how do those children and young people live? Because then we need to work for the services to make sure that we've got the right services in the right place. And Wirral, as we know, tends to be divided between west and east, and we have the entire socio-economic strata of the entire country living within our peninsula. Big demands on services